Good morning to all of you. So today we'll start with the revision of chapter number 12, Theorems Formula. After revising that, whatever time will be left, the chapter is lengthy, the surface area and volume, we'll revise that chapter in that much time. Right? Switch on those lights. Let us start with the revision of Theron's formula. With the help of Theron's formula, we can find out the area of a triangle in which height is missing. That means in case of scalene triangle, you can find out the area by using Theron's formula. Right? What is Theron's formula? According to Theron's formula, area of triangle is equal to square root of S. S minus A, S minus B, into S minus C, where S stands for semi-perimeter. For what S is there, S stands for semi-perimeter. S means perimeter over 2. That is sum of all sides in the perimeter. So S is A plus B plus C over 2. That is semi-perimeter. Perimeter divided by 2. This is known as S. Right? When we were doing the area of triangle, usually we use the formula R into base into height. Right? But this happens in the case of a triangle in which height is given, right? Right angle triangle, we can use this formula if height and base are given. Half into base into height, right? In case of isosceles triangle, where two sides are equal and one side is unequal, there also we can find out the same formula by finding out the height. Height find karke, half into base into height ho jayega. But if we are not able to find the height, then this also can be deducted by the formula S into S minus A, S minus B, S minus C under the root. So why this formula has been developed? This formula has been developed just to find the area of a triangle in which height is not given. And moreover, there is no method that we are having to find the height. Height find karne ka hamare paas na to koi method ho, na hi hamare paas height given ho. In that case, we used to utilize the area of the triangle to be the, with the Theron's formula, right? So I told you that where nothing is applicable, where nothing is available, then who comes there? Hero comes there, right? Na? Hero aata hai na, jab koi bhi hame filmon mein aap dekhte ho, jab koi bhi problem hoti hai, kuch bhi nahi soochta, to kaun aata hai us time pe? Hero aata hai na. Jaise Shaktiman serial mein Shaktiman aata hota tha. Waise hi, when we are not able to find the height and moreover height is not given, in that case, we'll use Theron's formula to find out the area of the triangle, right? Firstly, let us start with the equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle, that triangle in which all sides are equal, like this. Equilateral triangle, that triangle in which all sides are equal. So we can find the semi-perimeter like A plus A plus A over 2. S is equal to 3A over 2, right? So using the Theron's formula, we will derive the formula for the area of the equilateral triangle. As we have find out first target, first step will to find S, that we have find out sum of all sides divided by 2. That is A plus A plus A divided by 2. Now, area is equal to square root of S, S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. This is the formula for the area. Let us put the value of S. S is 3A by 2. This is 3A by 2 minus A, first side A, and S 3A minus 2, second side is also A because all sides are equal. And even the third side is A. So this is A. So we are having square root of 3a over 2, taking 2 as LCM, 2 हमने LCM लिया, तो again here it is, taking 2 as LCM, again we will be having, this is 3a, 2 multiplied by the a, this is minus 2a. Same step here, 2 taken as LCM, 3a minus 2a, and same step will follow here by taking the LCM, right? So further it is equal to square root of 3a over 2 multiply a over 2, 3a minus a, that means a by 2, and again a by 2, and again a by 2. So this we have put in the bracket, right? So further it is equal to square root of, so before writing the square root, we see that if we are getting the pair inside the square root, we can take them out, because now it's time to solve the square root. When you are doing the calculation inside the bracket, then you will find out the term out of the square, so that out of the square root, so that we can reach the final answer. See, this is 4 times a. We know that when in a square root that a number is occurring in the pair, one number can be taken out from that pair, right? A and a, 2 times they are occurring in the square root, so they will come at once. So these 2 a's I have combined. Similarly, these 2 a's will also be combined and they will come out as single a. This is single a. And similarly, from the denominator, these 2, they combine, come out as single 2, and these 2 combine, come out as single 2. And under the root, only one thing is left, that is 3. So this is equal to, this is root 3. This is equal to a square by 4 into root 3. In the sequence, we write it root 3 by 4 a square. So what is the area of equilateral triangle? You will remind it, you will remember it by heart, that it is, without verifying or without finding it, you should know what is the formula for the area of the equilateral triangle. This is equal to root 3 by 4 a square, where what is a? Side of the triangle. What is a? Side of the triangle. And in the equilateral triangle, side of the triangle is always given. Sometimes area is given to you in case of equilateral triangle. Usne bol diya area diya hua hai, side ki value nikalo. Then what you will do? See, suppose area of equilateral triangle, it is given to be say 36, and he says find the value of side. So what you will do? This is root 3 by 4 a square equal to 36, right? So a square is equal to 36 into 4 over root 3, right? So how you will find the side? Square shifts on the another side, becomes square root. That means a is equal to square root of 36 over 4 into root 3. So a, 36 ka square root 6, 4 ka 2, root 3 ka fir se square root. So let it be in the power form, root 3 ki power 1 by 2 and again power 1 by 2. This is power 1 by 4. So 12 over 3 raised to power 1 by 4 will be the answer. That is sometimes, otherwise whenever this kind of question is there, it will be like this, so that root 3 and root 3 get cancelled. Otherwise calculation, whatever kind of calculation you are having, you have to do. This was 3 raised to power 1 by 2. Root means 1 by 2. Again 1 by 2, multiply will give you 1 by 4. I'm just telling you that sometimes the question is like this, that you are given the area of the equilateral triangle, and with the help of that area, you have to find the side of the triangle. And it can also be asked that also find the perimeter of the triangle. So how you will find the perimeter after finding the side, Hardik? Side plus side plus side. That means when side will be added 3 times, you will get the perimeter of the triangle. So let us shift to the isosceles triangle. Yes. हाँ, 1.732 फिर उसका भी स्क्वायर रूट, राइट ना? चलो, So we are now shifting to isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle, that means in which two sides equal and one is non-equal. So let us take a triangle with two equal sides to be B and one non-equal side to be A. This, when we will derive the formula for the area of this isosceles triangle, you should again remember it like a formula. Okay? It is not necessary. So it should not be like this, that every time you derive it and then tell the answer. As you know, the area of the equilateral triangle root 3 by 4 a square. Without deriving it, you can tell me. Similarly, for isosceles triangle also, without deriving, you should tell. Let us firstly derive it. So, how to find? Firstly, you will find S. S means sum of all side divided by 2. That is perimeter over 2. So, it will become A plus 2B over 2. So, this comes out to be S. In the case of isosceles triangle, where B is the equal side and A is non-equal side, that is A plus 2B over 2. Let us find area. Area is equal to square root of S minus A, S minus B, and S minus C. Replacing the values, we will be having square root of S is A plus 2B over 2. S minus A, that means A plus 2B over 2 minus A. S minus B, that means A plus 2B over 2 minus B. S minus C, third side is equal. C stands for the third side. A, third side ki value hamare paas A hai. So put the value. This is A plus 2B over 2 minus A. Okay. So these two equal sides is each equal to B, and third side I am taking it to be A. Let us further solve it. So we will be having this is equal to square root of A plus 2B over 2. And then taking 2 as LCM, A plus 2B minus 2B. 2 get multiplied by B, will get it to be 2B, right? And then again taking 2 as LCM, this is A plus 2B minus 2B. Then again taking 2 as LCM, we are getting it to be A plus 2B minus 2A. So this we are getting. So further it is equal to square root of A plus 2B over 2. This 2B plus 2B minus 2B get cancelled. So we are having A by 2. Again it is A by 2. And this is 2B minus A over 2. Right? So up to this we can solve within the bracket, right? Now we are not going to multiply and all that. Just stop here only and see if anything can be taken out from the square root. If a thing, same thing is occurring in the pair in the square root, that can be taken out as a single number. So you can see that A by 2, it is occurring two times in the square root and would be written like this. Yeah. A by 2. 1 A by 2, we are taking it out. So this is 2B is positive. It is written first. So here 2B, you write it to be first. 2B plus A over 2. And in the second bracket, 2B minus A over 2. This we are having. So further it is equal to this is equal to A by 2 square root of. Now to solve it further, just solve the numerator with numerator and denominator with denominator. So I write numerators collectively and denominators again collectively. Right? Now in the numerator we see what we do. Let us wait for some time. We'll see what to do in the numerator. But in denominator again, 2 is occurring. Same number is occurring 2 times, and it will be taken out from the square root as a single 2. So this is a over 2. 2 2s come as single 2 out. This is 2b plus a into 2b minus a. So this is, so many students were asking about the syllabus of this exam. You all know that 4 chapters will be there, and whatever is excluded by CBSE that I will put in the group. Ki kis chapter mein se kya exclude hua, वैसे हम साथ साथ में बताती रही हूँ. Even then I will put in the group. So this is a over 4 square root of, to solve it. Yes, Kanishka.
Yes, good morning, ma'am.
Yes, Kanishka, speak up.
Good morning, ma'am.
हाँ जी, good morning.
मैम, मैंने ये पूछना है कि हमारा दिसंबर वाले एग्जाम्स में पिछला टर्म का सिलेबस आएगा?
मैं बच्चे, I will put in the group whatever is there. ठीक है?
Okay, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
So this is a plus b, a minus b. So what formula is here? A square minus b square. That means 2b square minus a square. So this is a by 4, 4b square minus a square. So this is the answer. A by 4, 4b square minus a square. And how you remember this? This will be remembered like this. This is b, b, a. The non-equal side over 4 under the root difference of the squares of the equal and the non-equal side, and equal side multiply by 4, right? How you will remember? Non-equal side by 4, square root may 4 times the square of the equal side minus square of the non-equal side. This is the way to remember the formula of the isosceles triangle, that equals non-equal side over 4, square root of 4 times square of the equal side minus square of the non-equal side. Right, so you should learn it like this only. Otherwise, the way is there that how you can develop this formula. Chaliye, next. So next we are going to start with. Let us do the applications of Heron's formula in different kind of questions. So we are given that sides of a triangle are in the ratio 3:5:7. Sides of the triangle are in the ratio 3:5:7, and its perimeter is 300. He says find its area. हमें एरिया फाइंड करना है और ट्राइंगल की साइड्स का रेशियो दिया हुआ है. सो वी नो दैट व्हेनेवर रेशियो ऑफ द साइड्स इज गिवन, रेशियो ऑफ एनीथिंग इज गिवन, वी सपोज दोस थिंग्स फर्स्ट, राइट? रेशियो इज गिवन 3:5:7. सो लेट द साइड्स बी, लेट द साइड्स बी 3x, 5x एंड 7x. So we have assumed the sides to be 3x, 5x and 7x, right? So now perimeter is given to be 300. So it means sum of all sides. Perimeter means sum of all sides. So we'll take it to be 3x plus 5x plus 7x. This is equal to 300. So we are given the perimeter 300. That is sum of all sides equal to 300. So this becomes 15x is equal to 300. So x is equal to 300 over 15. So x is equal to 20. So we are getting x is equal to 20, right? So we need to find the area of the triangle. To find the area, we need sides. As x is equal to 20, putting the value of the x in the different terms, different sides, you will get the value of the sides. Let us find the values of the sides. This is 3x, 3 into 20, 60. 5x, 5 into 20, 100. 7x, 7 into 20, this is 140. So these are the sides of the triangle as we are getting it to be 60, 100 and 140. So let us find the area of the triangle. For area, we need S as well. S, when perimeter is given, half of the perimeter will be the semi-perimeter. So perimeter is given to be 300, 150. And let me write the sides also. 60, 100, 140. These are the sides and this is the value of S. So you are having the value of S. Sides is with you, so you can find area of the triangle by using Heron's formula. Let us find area is equal to square root of S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. So this is equal to square root of 150. 150 minus 60, 150 minus 100, and 150 minus 140. So this is equal to 150 into 90 into 50 into 10. So from here, you have to think about a very calculatively that how you will prime factorize it and to get the numbers outside. Whenever there are four zeros, you see here it is 0, 0, 0, 0. Four times zeros, hai na? So aap 10 ko to pehle separate hi kar lo so that it can come out. 15 into 10 ho gaya. This is 9 into 10. This is 5 into 10 and this is single 10. Four times 10 hai, come out as 2 times 10. Whenever you are having even number of times zeros, you see in the square root, even number of times zeros, you separate it and get it out so that calculation becomes a little easy. So inside it is 15 into 9 into 5. So further it is equal to, further it is equal to 100 square root of, this 15 can be written as 3 into 5. No need to factorize 9 because we know that 9 is a perfect square. If a number is perfect square under the root, then no need to factorize that. This is 5. So we are having 100 into 9 square root 3, 5 into 5, 2 5s come out as single 5 outside, square root 3. So this is 1500 root 3 is the answer. 1500 root 3. Right? Let us do one more question based on Heron's formula. The question is, find the area of triangle whose two sides are given to be 18 centimeter and 10 centimeter. Given to be 18 centimeter and 10 centimeter. And the perimeter is 42. Perimeter is 42 centimeter. Two sides are given and perimeter is also given. And we want to find the area of the triangle. Hame find karna hai kya? Triangle ka area. Perimeter is 42 given hai. Kinka total karke? Bache, two sides are given. 18, 10. Third side is not given to us. Right? Third side is not given to us and that will be find by the clue of perimeter. Perimeter hame clue diya hua hai, with the help of which we can find out the third side. Because we know that the perimeter is sum of all the sides. So let the third side be x. So this will be x plus 18 plus 10, 42. X plus 28, 42. 42 minus 28. This is 14. Divide, why? Plus goes there, it will be subtracted. So x is equal to 14. So let us mark the three sides. Let a to be 14, b to be 18, and c to be 10. So we always name them as ABC, because in Heron's formula, standard abbreviation ABC for three sides we are taking. Chaliye. Let us further solve it. Area is equal to square root of S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. And that is equal to, what was S? We are having perimeter 42, and from there out S is 42 over 2, that is 21. So S is 21, replacing the value 21. 21 minus 14, 21 minus 18, and 21 minus 10. So this is equal to 21 into 7 into 3 into 11. 21 into 7 into 3 into 11. So very intelligently we will prime factorize it. 21 can be written as 7 into 3. 7 can't be prime factorized further. 3 and even 11 will be written as it is. Out of two numbers, one number will be taken out. 7, 7, 7, 3, 3, 3, root 11. So this is 21 root 11 centimeter square. 21 root 11 centimeter square. Let us start with the next question based on the Heron's formula. Yes, an isosceles triangle. So now we are talking about isosceles triangle. It is having the perimeter 30 centimeter. Perimeter is 30 centimeter. Isosceles triangle mein jo perimeter hai, that is 30 centimeter, and each of the equal side is 12 centimeter. Each equal side is 12 centimeter. So perimeter of the isosceles triangle is 30 centimeter, and each equal side is 12 centimeter. Then find the area of the triangle. That means out of the three sides, two sides are with us. Third side is not there. So without having even a single side, we can't reach the area. So firstly, we'll find the third side. Let us suppose the third side to be X. Let the third side be X, right? So perimeter is 30. Below perimeter, you write sum of all sides, that is 12 plus 12 plus x equal to 30, that is 24 plus x is equal to 30. So x is equal to 30 minus 24, x is equal to 6. So this way you are getting the third side of the triangle, that comes out to be 6. So let us start with the area. So area of triangle is equal to square root of S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. So S, semi-perimeter, that is perimeter over 2, that is 30 over 2, which is 15. So replacing S by 15, this is 15. 15 minus 12, 15 minus 12, into 15 minus 6. So this is further equal to 15 into 3 into 3 into 9. So this is 3 into 5 into 3 into 3 into 9. No need to factorize 9 because it is a perfect square number. So out of two threes, single 3 come out. This is single 3. Out of 9 square root, this is 3. And 5 will be inside the bracket. This is, even 1 3 is there inside the bracket. 5 into 3. This is 9 root 50 centimeter square. Right? So you can solve the different questions. Certain examples are there from net, from different books to enhance your calculation regarding the prime factorization of the square root and coming out. चलिए लेट अस डू वन मोर क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन द कॉस्ट प्राइस एंड ऑल दैट. देयर इज अ ट्रायंगुलर वॉल with sides 122 meter, 22 meter and 120 meters. The sides of the walls are 122 meter, 22 meter and 120 meters. The this wall is used for advertisement and certain cost and certain price was charged for this advertisement by the owner of the wall. So that is a different thing, that how he's charging the person. That is a different thing. First of all, we have to see that how much area being used for advertisement. For that we need what? We need area of the wall. So first of all, we'll find the area of the wall, that is indirectly the area used for advertisement. चलिए S semi perimeter A plus B plus C over 2, 122 plus 22 plus 120 over 2, this is 4, 6 and 2 over 2, this becomes 264 over 2 and that is 132 centimeter. So A plus B plus C over 2, that is 264 over 2 and that is equal to 132. We want to find area. So area is equal to square root of S, S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. So this is equal to square root of 132. 132 minus 122, 132 minus 22 and 132 minus what? 132 minus 120. So this is further equal to 132 into 10 into 100 into 12. 132 into 10 into 100 into 12, right? So this is further equal to, firstly see that we no need to prime factorize 100 because 100 square root 10 can be taken out as it is. What is left? 132 into 10 into 12. Let us prime factor. Otherwise, so it's very easy. It is 11 into 12. 12, 12, bahar aa jayega. But sometimes students find it difficult to write it directly. So I just advise them to prime factorize thoroughly as you want. Right? So hum isko prime factorize agar kare 2 ke table pe, 2 into 66, 66 further, 2 into 33, 33 further, 11 into 3. So 132 prime factorize as 2 into 2 into 11 into 3. ठीक है, देख लो, चेक कर लो. 2 2s are 4, 4 3s are 12, 12 into 11, 132. Right, 10, 5 into 2. And then 12, 12, otherwise you can do it like 2, 2s are 4, 3s are 12. 132 minus 122 भी है तो वो 100. ओ सॉरी, दिस इज, अच्छा दिस 110 ऐसे रहे. दिस यू वांट टू से, चलो फिर एक तो चलाकी हम कर ही सकते हैं ना जो हमने सीख ली है. चलो ये स्टूडेंट्स विल कंटिन्यू टुमारो, द पीरियड इज ओवर. टुमारो आई विल टेल यू द वे टू कैलकुलेट.